Looking for the King of Podcasts? You're in the wrong channel. Looking for good ideas for life? You are far from good hands. If you think the listener is always right, you are far from the right place. Hosted by Northeasterner by birth, a rebel by choice. If you want a host that floats between love and madness, then play on and listen to Crazy Train Radio.
You drive me wild.
What up, Crazy Train Radio?
You look like hell.
And I could look the same.
What's the photo for?
You want answers? I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Truth, 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 truth,
I love scotch. I love scotch. Scotch is got scotch. Here it goes down, down into my belly.
What's it open?
Say it! Say it!
Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it. Say it.
Don't mess with me. I'm one crazy loofo.
Brand is truly exciting and so glad that they are starting to make a positive impact. Little Bean Soapery is a woman-owned small business based in Northeast Pennsylvania. Little Bean Soapery does so much as all products are handcrafted and offer many different things for both men and women. Soaps, scrubs, body butters, bath bombs, solid cologne, and much more. Little Bean Soapery also does things for special occasions such as birthdays, Mother's Day, Father's Day, and special seasonal gift sets. But also, let's not forget large orders for party favors by request. The great things about all products is that they are crafted to be nourishing on the skin. If you wish to check them out, please feel free to visit littlebeansoapery.com. Any questions, please feel free to also email littlebeansoapery@gmail.com for custom inquiries and or ask anything else you wish. Tell them that Elena from Crazy Train Radio sent ya.
This is Jennifer Larm from Diamonds and Whiskey, and you are listening to Crazy Train Radio.
Hey folks, it's your least favorite host in the podcast world, Croc, Jonathan Steele. Boy, do we have a good one for you today.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. This next guest is out of the great city of Charlotte, North Carolina, and she is the lead singer of his country rock band with a new single called Walk Hard. She is a combination of barroom beauty, backwood danger, and a beauty queen that can be a hellraiser all in one. The band is Diamonds and Whiskey, and this guest is Jennifer Larm. Good evening.
Hi, how you doing?
I can't complain. Nobody listens anyway. So.
I know that feeling.
Oh, yeah. As from our discussion earlier, and I won't throw personal business out there, but definitely got that feeling as well. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, hubby. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Right.
So first and foremost, walk hard. What can you tell us before I go ahead and insert that into this conversation?
Well, walk hard is, it's got, you know, it's kind of your cheating breakup story, but with a twist. It's more about how we tend to drag our baggage from past relationships into the new one. You know, when you've been hurt really bad, especially as a woman, we tend to be a little jealous, a little, you know, overly worried about things. And so the line in the hook is walk hard on down that line because my heart's still doing time. So it's about talking to the next person, telling what happened before, and then, you know, she's angry and she doesn't want to trust anybody. So that's really the story. And I mean, who can't really relate to that? I mean, we've all, most of us have been hurt in our lives, you know? So, yeah, that's where it comes from. But the song, the music is just kick ass. It's, you know, it's more about like just walking hard through life, but that's kind of what the music lends to. So yeah, that's kind of the gist of the story.
So why don't I go ahead and put that right maybe here?
She took what was mine on a long hot summer day. Fire in her eyes, said she stole my life away. Forever must have only meant till you found something new. 'Cause I gave you my everything and now she gets all of you. So walk hard on down that line. 'Cause no fault of yours, but you'll have to dearly pay. Thought I had it all, but the lies got in the way. You pick up the pieces, try to find them while you can. There ain't no way in hell that I could ever trust a man. So walk.
Coming out of Walk Hard, that very kick-ass sounding song, that's for sure. So first off, before I continue, where is it available? And do you do physical medium as well, besides your usual spots like Spotify and such?
Yes, yeah, so it is available literally everywhere right now. The music video, the official music video, is coming to YouTube within the next week or two. We'll be talking about the release date for that soon. But yes, it's available everywhere. And the record itself, Blonde Ambition, which has Walk Hard on it, we're planning to release in late February, and there will be physical copies available as well.
And I'm guessing you will have that stuff at shows and all that.
Yes. You can catch it at our tour. You know, our first album, we sold out of those on tour, Heartbreak Queen. We'll have that record and Blonde Ambition available when we go out on show to shows this year.
Well, absolutely. I will have links to website or TikTok, Facebook, all that social media things that those young kids use. But that being said, I want to bring up Heartbreak Queen, which was the debut album from 2019. So between that one and the new album, which again, you can find Walk Hard and stuff on there, besides digital versions, how would you compare the two albums?
Well, production-wise, they're completely different. The first album was more raw. You know, it was my first album I've never recorded before. So, you know, my band did it. It was amazing. Now, the songs were stories about my life then. Blonde Ambition, a new record, stories from my life. Heartbreak Queen is the first 10 songs I ever wrote. Blonde Ambition is the second 10 songs I ever wrote. So, you know, I've been carrying on kind of storytelling through my life in different places. Production wise, though, they're wildly different. The production, I really went more high end this time. Eddie Z produced this in Charlotte, but Kirk Kelsey, who's front of house mixer for Keith Urban, done Creed record before. I mean, he's amazing. He mixed the record. Grammy winners are on it playing. I went kind of ham on this album. So it's a lot different in that way, but you're still going to get a mix of types of music. You got everything from pop to country to rock to blues to ragtime, even on this record. So you're getting in bluegrass. You've got bluegrass on this one. So every song's different. I'm not stuck in one genre. I mean, we are a country rock group, kind of Southern rock with some country, but yeah, I write from the heart and it's honest and whatever comes out and that's what you're going to get.
And it's funny how that tends to happen, especially from the singer-songwriter aspect. But I would think the one thing that has been a big change in Pi inspire a lot of influence, and I can always take this out if too personal, but I do know from a couple hours ago, you have a 3-year-old that runs around. So how much influence is your child in what you do musically?
Well, she inspires me daily in my musical career. When I started playing music, I was very young. I was about her age, actually. But I didn't get into really this band thing until much later in life. But now, more than anything, I want her to know that she can chase any dream and do anything she wants to do if she works hard enough for it. So I take her on the road. She gets on stage with me. She was at rehearsal earlier today with me. She has her own mic, her own guitar, her own piano. Like she, so while I feel like I'm inspiring her, she is a huge part of this for me. She inspires me musically. You know, we're experiencing it together. And I think that that's a really beautiful thing.
And I just want to give a quick rundown, because like you said, you started at close to her age and such. And correct me if any of it is wrong, because we all know the stuff that's on this interweb or internet is always 100% accurate. But we heard, and it's funny that you got it in the background, but you started learning piano at 4. You started realizing your vocal abilities close to 8. Then you had classical training to be a first soprano and doing traditional hymns and such. So was there a certain point, because obviously at different stages there, you had different elements incorporated to what we are today. But was there a certain point you realized there was a whole package? Hey, I might be able to do something with this.
Yeah, it was about 3 years ago. I thought I was going to go on and sing opera. I mean, I was very good. I'd won many awards and competed as a soprano in our state in high school and then the early years of college. But then life changed and things happened. So I kind of got away from it for a while. It would take me another probably 10 to 12 years to get back to playing music. And by then, a lot had happened in life. And so I didn't know I could write songs until pretty recently. And yeah, it I was going through cancer, Lyme disease. You know, I've been through a lot. My son, my oldest, he was 1 pound when he was born. He had a trach and a feeding tube till he was 10. And so I've had a lot happen in life. And so I had a lot to write about then. So I started playing music again as therapy. And then, I don't know, somehow people started liking it. And then next thing I know, I'm recording this record I wrote. And then next thing I know, we're opening for major acts. And now we're touring the country in a bus this year. I mean, it just kind of like, and I say next thing I know, but I worked my butt off at it because I don't know how to not give 1,000% to something. But yeah, just kind of the last 3.5 years, 4 years have been crazy. I didn't plan on it going this way, but here we are and I'm loving every second of it and life is good.
So correct me if I'm wrong. And I'm like, or trying to wrap my head around the answer again, first day, new mouth. But so you said there, we have 2 kids, one with who dealt with some serious stuff early on. You had Lyme's disease, cancer. We're dealing with everyday life stuff. But then let's factor in this little sprinkle of almost 2 years, COVID and all. So it's like, not, you didn't say COVID, but it's like,
yeah, that happened too, though.
Yeah. I'm not putting that in your mouth, but how are you wrapping your head around all this stuff?
Well, you know,
how do you keep yourself sane? I should say.
People ask me that all the time because I had a pretty rough childhood. And then, I've had Lyme disease since I was 12 and was very sick most of my life, you know, over 20 some years now. You know, I was in 3 car accidents in 2020. I have had foot surgery last year. I couldn't walk for about 18 months. Like I've been through a lot. And so, but my father only had one arm. He lost his arm before I was born. And mostly used a leg for a long time. And this man got up every day and worked his butt off. He didn't sit around. He didn't wallow in self-pity. And he told me all the time that where there's a will, there's a way. And you have to be thankful for every little thing in life and never complain. Life's not fair. It's never going to be fair. If you think it's going to be fair, you're sadly mistaken. So if you set yourself up to believe that, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. So I was raised with this tough man that just got up every day and kept going through all of his pain. And I felt like I had no reason to ever complain and nothing to ever get down about. So anytime something happens, I just keep on pounding. And, you know, my son was 1 pound when he was born and he's had multiple surgeries. We went through 10 years of just craziness. And he taught me so much about life because this kid never once complained, never said it's not fair. He's just every day we got up and kicked the day in the butt. And I don't know. I just feel like no matter what comes my way, I'm going to beat it, you know, and, or I'm going to try like hell one way or the other. And that's pretty much the message I want to send with my music is you can get through things. You're not alone. You're not the only one. So yeah, that's kind of how I keep myself sane anyway. And I stay busy. You know, don't let your mind get idle. Don't get dragged down by everything in your mind. Stay busy.
Well, I want to ask you one more musical question, but I reached over to my desk as you were answering there. And thank God for wireless headphones there. But when we are done, the reason I reached over to my desk was I have a bottle of whiskey that I crack only time to time. I'm not a super huge drinker, even though I make jokes about it on the show. But tonight, I definitely want to have one in our show mugs for not just you, not just your son and father, but just telling your story. I want to have one in honor of all the fighters in the world, because it's folks like you that keep stuff going and keep this world turning and trying to be positive influences.
Well, I'm honored. Thank you. That means a lot to me. It really does. I love it.
And I've had the fortunate, I'm going to put this down before I drop it and spill everywhere. Then I'll have a real reason to cry. But sorry, I needed a second there to get myself together, which is
honey, you're fine.
very, very unlike me. even in serious moments. But musically, obviously you have a lot of inspiration personally with the family and yourself and everything else. But I've heard you've had some pretty good inspiration as far as musical acts. And the one common thread that I've seen over the past 6 months with on a musical side and some of the acts has been Dolly Parton, but also I heard Hart and Rob Thomas and or Tori Amos. There's a lot of mixture, even a little bit of Eminem as influences. So
yeah.
Am I wrong with that list of influences?
Or no, you did your homework. So all of them are amazing. I listen to everything from jazz to country to, you know, just anything, but I definitely dig in with artists that can write. Writers are, you know, incredible to me. Rob Thomas to me is one of the best songwriters ever walked the earth. So I really resonate with people that tell their story. Tori Amos, she has a story to tell. That Little Earthquakes record got me through my late teens and early 20s. And, but you know, Dolly stands out to me above everybody. And I'll tell you why. It's not because of her songwriting or anything like that. And I talk about this a lot in interviews. It's her character. You know why we all love Dolly Parton? It's her dang character. And to me, everybody's like, oh, I'm going to be like Dolly. Yeah, but do you know what that really means? You know what that really means? It doesn't mean that you're a great singer or a songwriter. That means that your character stands out above everyone's. And that's because your heart is so good. And when I realized that as I got older, I realized that that's really what I wanted to do in my career. I wanted my character to shine. And the way we do that is we be kind all the time, whether people deserve it or not. We're kind, you know, and my band is like, we live by this. Everywhere we go, we're going to be the nicest people you could ever meet. We're going to give as much as we can. And we're not going to do this because we love the money or anything like that. We're going to do it because we want to help people and we want to inspire. And I think that's what makes her a cut above the rest. And, you know, this little sticker to say, what would Dolly do? You know, they're cute and all, but do you really live like that? Do you ever wake up one day and say, what can I do for somebody today? Instead of, oh, what can I do to make my day better? You know, and those are the little things I think we all should be doing or trying to do. And then humanity as a whole would be healthier. And so that's, I really feel that in my soul, and that's how I want to live. So I look at people's character and, you know, I think that's what makes us stand out.
And I don't say this to kiss ass, because I think folks who listen to this show realize that. But with that answer you just gave, I was sitting there thinking about and really trying to digest what you were saying there. And she could see me on camera as I'm thinking about this and actually focusing and listening. But during that answer, you know who you sounded a lot like? And I would like to really hope I can connect you guys post this conversation is, I don't know if you've ever heard of her, Miss Ally Colleen.
No, I haven't heard of her.
But you haven't? She is a young, up-and-coming artist that she just kicks ass just as well. And
I'll check it out. Sure.
I'll send you over the info and to everybody to the contact I have for you. But check her out. Look up Ally Colleen on Instagram. She's very active there. But just something about your personality that I'm getting here and my dealings with her. There's just something there that you have a similar mindset there, which is just awesome. And I think you would appreciate her. And I think she would, I'm going to let her know as well. I think she'd appreciate you and what Diamonds and Whiskey do.
I would love that. I absolutely love it. And I'm a big proponent of females in particular. Like you know, I'm a mom. I would love to inspire and also be inspired. And I am by so many women. So anyone I could meet, you know, I would love that. Absolutely love it.
And I know I can hook you up, and I hope she don't mind me saying this, and this is no pressure. I think I can connect you with a great artist out of Nashville named Dallas Remington or Janelle Author, who worked with Dolly with her single that came out last year. And I mean, there's just so many of these young independent female artists and bands that is, there's just certain vibe. I can't describe it with all you guys. So if I can help facilitate something, I'm not saying I'm the end all be all, but there's just something about you guys, this group of young artists that I've gotten to deal with.
That's amazing. That's really awesome. Well, Blonde Ambition, my record is a nod, you know, to Dolly. It's about being who you want to be and secure in yourself. And that's really what the title and the title track is all about. And so, yeah, she's my hero.
Yeah. So I will definitely be in touch to point you in some of these directions, because I think you would, and I'm going to let some of them know as well that you guys would, there's, like I said, there's just something, there's a good, wholesome, positive vibe. I can't describe it, but it's awesome. But last thing I want to bring up to you is, and I know I saw her earlier, your fiddle player is with you, but you said she's from LA.
Yeah, she's out here this week. We are on the Carolina Country Music Awards. We're playing it tomorrow. And so, and we're up for Country Tour of the Year and New Emerging Artists. So she's out here. We went to Pennsylvania to play a gig and came back. And now we had to go shopping today, of course, to get outfits. Got to show up dressed to the nines. But yeah, she's here till Sunday. So I'm really excited to have her out. And she's flew all over the country, or yeah, flew everywhere this summer to meet us and played on tour with us. And she'll be with us again. We leave for tour in March. We're opening for David Lee Murphy for several dates. And then we're kind of all over the place again this summer. So it's going to be a wild year.
And definitely you're going to have some party crowds there for David Lee Murphy. That's for sure.
I like that. Yeah.
Yeah. Country's my home base for music. So.
I see.
So, yeah, most people would think with the show title it's rock and all, but it's not.
That's Jennifer, awesome.
Yeah. Jennifer Larne is the lead singer of Diamonds and Whiskey. And like I said, I'm going to send links to the website and the social medias and all that fun stuff. But out of all that, where's the best spot people can see for you?
Or
connect with you.
Yeah. So Facebook and Instagram, and we're on Twitter. Facebook is, you know, Diamonds and Whiskey. Instagram, Diamonds and Whiskey Official. Twitter, we're Diamonds Whiskey. They won't let us have the and. I don't know. We're not big on Twitter, but we're there. TikTok is blowing up. It's Diamonds and Whiskey on TikTok. We just posted a snippet of Warrior song coming out on our record, which you're going to love. I know. But yeah, so we're anywhere you want to find us. You can just type it in Google and everything will pop up. And we're getting ready to post all our tour dates on our website. We're having our website rebuilt. That's going to be up this coming week. And diamondsandwhiskeyband.com. And yeah, you can just check us out. We're going to be on some major festivals this year. So we'll be announcing all of that. And come look us up. Send us a message. We always respond.
And how appropriate, and I mentioned it earlier because of everything, that I have, have a bottle of whiskey here. We'll have a drink for you guys and all the fighters, like I said. Jennifer Larne, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. I enjoyed this. Thank you for being patient with me. You're amazing. I hope I talk to you again sometime.
Absolutely, and hope to see you down the road in person during one of these shows. Hey there, Friday fans. We know how much you enjoy the movies. Enjoy grabbing your Friday merchandise and interacting with the Friday family, whether it be at conventions or during our particular watch-alongs. Well, when you're looking to get yourself masks, why not check out our friends over at Camp Blood Customs out of New York State, and order your specific custom mask from any of the films. All orders are made specifically. Your needs and wants are. Make sure you find Camp Blood Customs on Facebook, Instagram, and all over social media, and order yours today.
Hey, you guys, this is Allie Pauline, and you are listening to Crazy Train Radio.